Hello everyone, and many thanks for your interest. When I look at the moon, I see craters, craters, and more craters of different sizes. And I'm asking myself, where are all these craters coming from? You know, in looking for an explanation, a scientific explanation, is that many years ago, millions of years ago, both the Earth and the Moon were bombarded by meteorites or asteroids. And obviously because Earth has an atmosphere, these bodies didn't reach the surface. Whereas in the case of the Moon, with no atmosphere at the time, you know, they impacted the surface and created these numerous craters. I mean, I'm not completely happy with this explanation, because when you look at the moon, most of the craters are really shallow. If a body impacts another body at such a speed, it creates a big hole, and most of the craters on the moon are really shallow. Really, really shallow. And also, in recent years, we found more than 6,000 new craters on the moon. I mean, this is not being publicized on mainstream media, and it should be big news if this activity is happening on the moon. 6,000 new craters on the moon of different sizes. Really shallow. So, a plausible explanation for this amount of craters is basically that because the moon is being mined by extraterrestrials, in the process of mining, they're creating these new craters. You know, they scoop in the regolith, doing the processing that they have to do to collect the resources, the materials, and in that process, the discarded regolith is put on the side, forming hills, you know, create a rim like hills. And that's what we're seeing right now, because the new craters that we see, they're not completely circular, spherical. Some of them have funny shapes, and some of them appear as incomplete, and that's because they're artificially created and they don't have complete closed rims around them. I think this explanation made sense to me. I'm not sure what you think about it, but it does make sense to me. And what I picture in my mind is this huge mining infrastructure in place, you know, big machines working on the moon, you know, selecting an area of the moon, scooping the regolith out, collecting the refining the regolith and doing all the processing to condense the helium-3 and have it ready for distribution. So in this scenario, the moon is a big reservoir of energy sources for many civilizations, and as a consequence of this, you see so much activity on the moon. You know, a lot of vessels coming to negotiate and to buy or to trade this precious gas and, you know, take it to the places. And the extraction of helium-3, although it's relatively easy, is still time consuming, so there has to be order and organization on the moon to be able to process vast amounts of it. I mean, the reservoir, the reserves of helium-3 on the moon could actually provide the energy that our civilization, humans, need for 1,000 years. Helium-3 is mostly concentrated on the media on the moon. That's what we know. But I think there is also high concentrations of it on the highlands, where we see so many craters. Now, on the media, we know that because we map out the areas a few years back through a special multi-spectral imaging system that we sent out to orbit the moon through lunar orbiters, we found out that the high concentrations were on the media, particularly on Tranquilitatis and Ocean Procellarum. And we confirmed that with the Apollo 11 in 69, through the samples that we collected. But I think there's also high concentrations of titanium dioxide on the highlands, deeper than 3 meters. I mean, the highlands are composed of an orthosite, which is a porous rock. A helium-3 could easily escape, but if an orthosite is found deeper than 3 meters, then because of the cold, it will keep it. And I think that's the mining that is being done on the highlands to get the anorthosite out and to, get the gas. So the picture that I have in my mind is that there's so many new craters on the moon because of this mining taking place. And, I picture these big machineries on a specific section on the highlands, doing mining at a vast scale. Is, first they have to process the ilmenite. Ilmenite is a mineral where titanium dioxide is found, hence helium-3. So these big machines are mining the ilmenite, and then they refine it through heat. So they have these solar panels, collecting the sun power during daytime and reflecting it to solar dishes that they have to concentrate the sun power, because regulate the ilmenite, the titanium dioxide, it needs to be heated up to 750 degrees Celsius to be able to release the gases, the helium-3. So these small fractions of regolith are put in chambers, heated up, and various gases are released. And byproducts are water, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, iron. So essential elements for survival, for residual atmosphere. And then obviously the helium-3, which during nighttime needs to be cool down in special chambers through cryogenerators to be able to, put it together into packets ready for distribution. And I mentioned that these mining processes are byproducts, water, oxygen. I mean, that's what we need to survive, to breathe. So there is an atmosphere being created, and this residual atmosphere is actually localized right now on all these small craters. So really, it makes sense that once you finish exploiting a section of the moon and you're creating these craters, because the residual regolith is put on the side creating those rims, you're also creating this habitat, localized habitat that has an atmosphere, and you can easily put a glass dome on it. And get people to move in and live in there, because there is air in there, and eventually this atmosphere will spread out to the whole, moon, terraforming the moon, everywhere basically. I mean logically this explains the amount of domes that we see when we observe the moon, of glassy consistency. I mean, this has enormous implications for our understanding of the purpose of the moon. It is there not just for the sake of being there, it has multi-purpose. And one of the big purposes for the moon being there is that He could be our savior. You know, we know that we're not gonna have fossil fuels forever. They'll be depleted in a few years' time. And how are we going to provide energy resources for billions of humans on Earth? Impossible. Helium-3 is the answer, and it's on the moon in vast quantities. So we try all this out with the Apollo missions, but we were stopped. I mean, we need to look after ourselves first, sort out our differences, and evolve spiritually before we are accepted to go somewhere else in space. And obviously, the races established on the moon, they know this. They're not going to allow other races to come in, knowing that that race, you know, is killing each other through wars and stupid things. But at some point, as I mentioned in my previous video, we have to put our act together, sort out our differences of, you know, political and religion and whatever, and live in peace. And to guarantee the survival of the species, we have to, you know, reach an agreement to be allowed to exploit these resources. I mean, the moon is the closest body that we have. It is our moon. But is it really? A lot of food for thought, isn't it? Thank you. Thanks for watching. Bye.